Hello, I'm Michael Cusumano, a professor and currently deputy dean for faculty at the MIT Sloan School of Management. Generative AI holds enormous disruptive potential across many industries, but these complex systems require specialized hardware and software. That brings us to NVIDIA, the semiconductor firm whose technology powers approximately 80% of generative AI applications. In this video, which is based on a column I wrote for Communications of the ACM in January 2024, we'll explore NVIDIA's story and answer some key questions. How did NVIDIA become such a central player in the generative AI ecosystem, especially in hardware? What strategic moves enabled its rise? And what challenges does NVIDIA face in the future? Let's start with a quick look back at NVIDIA's history. Founded in 1993, NVIDIA focused early on graphics cards for PCs. By 2002, revenue exceeded $1 billion. Today, NVIDIA is the world's most valuable semiconductor company, with a staggering $1 trillion market cap. They're a leader in what we now call graphic processing units, or GPUs, used for gaming, AI, and many other applications. How has NVIDIA managed to dominate this GPU market? One key strategic move was to introduce a simplified parallel processing architecture in 2006, enabling efficient distribution of workloads across many compute cores or subprocessors simultaneously. This established NVIDIA as an early leader in graphics processing. Another pivotal decision in 2006 was to launch CUDA, a free software development kit to access GPU hardware instruction sets for parallel processing. CUDA could run on various computers as long as they had access to NVIDIA GPUs. It became particularly important that NVIDIA tailored CUDA software for industry-specific applications. This has led to the wider deployment of NVIDIA GPUs, not only in gaming, but also in areas such as artificial intelligence and machine learning, cryptocurrency mining, virtual reality software, self-driving vehicles, robotics, and data center cloud services. Now, why are GPUs from NVIDIA so useful for artificial intelligence and machine learning? Let's start with the difference between GPUs and CPUs. CPUs are the central processing units, also known as microprocessors, that power most functions in our computers. They typically have dozens or at most a few hundred compute cores, and each can perform complex tasks. By contrast, GPUs have thousands of simpler processing cores that operate in parallel. Each one can control a few pixels on a screen, such as in a video game, or control other simple tasks, like identifying parts of objects for pattern matching. And they work at lightning speed and in parallel. These capabilities make GPUs perfectly suited to the complex mathematical operations underpinning neural networks and other machine learning and AI applications. As early as 2006, some academics began using NVIDIA consumer graphic cards to train primitive neural networks. More famous work happened later around 2011 and 2012. In response, NVIDIA invested aggressively in specialized software libraries and AI programming tools, with a particularly important CUDA software release in 2014 for building deep learning neural networks. In 2016, NVIDIA introduced GPU systems tailored for data center AI workloads. They also spurred ecosystem growth by donating servers to universities as well as OpenAI, then a nonprofit research laboratory. In 2022, NVIDIA optimized its new Hopper GPU architecture and CUDA platform specifically for large language models and inference engines powering new generative AI software. Hopper includes more CPU-like capabilities, as well as thousands of compute cores and staggering amounts of memory, all meant to supercharge generative AI applications. So what has enabled NVIDIA's incredible financial results in recent years? First, market demand for NVIDIA GPUs has outpaced supply. This supply-demand imbalance, especially from 2017, has led to high prices and profits and a trillion-dollar valuation. Second, NVIDIA's CUDA software platform has benefited from a virtuous cycle between software and hardware adoption. The more GPU-optimized apps that use CUDA software, the more demand they create for NVIDIA hardware among developers and data centers. This self-reinforcing dynamic powers increasing sales and profits. Though currently dominant, NVIDIA also faces growing competition in the GPU space from two main directions. First, major chip makers are already challenging NVIDIA's latest offerings. AMD is targeting NVIDIA's new H100 chip with its next-generation MI300X line. Intel's Gaudi 2 GPU also directly competes with the H100 for technical workloads. Neither works with CUDA software, however. Startups like SambaNova and Cerebras have raised billions of dollars to design new GPU hardware and software platforms as well. Second, large cloud service providers are developing their own proprietary chips to reduce reliance on NVIDIA GPUs. Google has its Tensor Processing Units, or TPUs. AWS launched its Trainium chip, and Microsoft is planning a custom chip for its data centers. In the meantime, Meta has its own in-house effort underway. On the software side, NVIDIA's proprietary CUDA software has helped lock in users to its ecosystem. However, developers complain that CUDA is closed source, complex, and requires familiarity with the relatively difficult programming languages C and C++. In response, NVIDIA has expanded CUDA support to more popular languages like Python. But rivals AMD and Intel have open sourced their alternative GPU programming frameworks to attract more developers. There are also some open source options available to programmers, such as OpenCL, introduced in 2009, based on the C language. Additionally, new languages have emerged, like OpenAI's Triton, launched in 2021 for Python GPU programming. Google also has programming tools for its Tensor Processing Units, though no one can match the libraries and tools available through CUDA. In conclusion, NVIDIA currently leads the ecosystem enabling generative AI. However, it faces growing competition in both hardware and software. AMD, Intel, major cloud providers, and the open source community are all exploring alternatives to NVIDIA's hardware and software. At the same time, demand for high-performance AI computing continues to grow very rapidly. Ultimately, NVIDIA's ability to couple its proprietary hardware with unique software and to keep innovating in its technology will determine how long the company remains at the center of the generative AI ecosystem.